So welcome back from the session where we left, and I'm really thank you for asking questions and paying attention towards the presentation. So as I said earlier, who are going to bridge the gaps? So the institute like us, IBSC, and there are so many other people who are helping to bridge the gap between the academia and the industry. Because several times, you must have heard several times, and you must have experienced that sometimes academic knowledge is not helpful, much helpful in the industry when we actually do the job, right? And that's why skilling is very important to build our competency level from level 1 to level 5 is extremely important in your career. So Raj GPRIC is helping all the professional to build their career in whichever field they want to, you know, whether it is QA, RA, or any QMS, internal auditor, lead auditor, or whichever field you are interested in, we are there to help you always. As I said, we are offering various courses online and offline. And if anyone would like to take advantage of those courses, please come forward or recommend these courses to your colleagues, your friends in your company or wherever you feel so. If you are satisfied, then only you, you can recommend the courses. We are not forcing anyone to, come and join our courses. When it gives the satisfaction to you, when you feel really from your heart that, yes, I learned something from Raj GPRIC, and now, I can recommend, then only it is allowed. And I'm sure, you would love to complete this course and have certification with you. So, not taking much time, I would announce the program which we are going to cover during these 3 months. So those who have already taken the admission with IBSC and paid the fees to Nituri Naresh online, those people can just focus on what I'm going to, tell about this course curriculum. So this course is for a 3 months weekend program. As I said, Saturdays, there will be a lecture from 5:30 to 8:30. Sometimes if the trainers are not available, Sunday, we have to organize the lectures. So this course starts with, the introduction to various medical device regulatory bodies. Mainly we are focusing on 3 bodies, that is India, Europe, and USA, you would see. So this will be the training which would be cover overview of the, all these 3 bodies and the quality management system required as per the ISO 13485. Okay. So when we talk about ISO 13485, with that, we try to cover all the clauses with the case studies, examples, industry examples, and along with the, internal audit, which you are going to face in whichever organization you would be, doing your job. And then the third module, the first module is introduction, second is the QMS, third is the risk management and the risk analysis, in which we are going to cover as per ISO 14971, all the risk hazards, risk control, right from risk identification, risk control, risk mitigation, so everything will be covered under this as per ISO 14971. Then we cover technical file preparation for the medical device registration, which is required for US, Europe, and India. So this program is basically based on the QA and the RA concept. The RA is the regulatory affairs, in which the submission to the notified body and the regulatory bodies is very important, right? So when we talk about the submission, everything comes into like preparation of technical file, then aligning all the document, finding out the gap, filling out those gaps, and then compilation and submission. So when we talk about the India, we teach you about all the Indian filing for ABCD type of devices and the submission through the Sugam portal. When we talk about the US FDA, we teach you 510K PMA submission through the US FDA ESG gateway. And of course, we teach you CE mark and the European submission as well. So trust our experience to boost your career in pharma, medical device, biotech, nutra, and you know all other fields. As I said, we offer classroom in-house training and the hands-on training program in different areas. Also, we offer services for the medical devices, nutraceutical, biotech, and the pharmaceuticals. So if you need any USA agent, you know, to build your, even from MDD to MDR, you are looking for implementation because transition phase is going on, still we have time and opportunity, to rework on this MDD to MDR. And those who are already implemented quality management system and MDR, those who are willing to export their product to US, Europe, Canada, Japan, or whichever country, you know, in your scope, we are there to help you out. And we take care of everything, like right from technical documentation, auditing, and everything. So this is our institute located in Thane, Majibada. If you happen to come, please come. And these are our students. Past student, and you will refer to our website www.rajpharmaelearning.com. These are our past batch students who have given the testimonial, I would say, and some of them are our guest speaker also. We invite Arun Gujade and other people also to come and share their knowledge with all our students. So as a training partner, as I said, this is a 3-month course of 50 hours. And those who are taken the admission, we will form a WhatsApp group. So you have to give your WhatsApp number to Neeta Naik. Neeta Naik is our admin head who takes care of admission, then sharing of PPT guidances and everything. So whatever PPT or guidances, if you don't receive anything from us, just remind her and she will do the needful. So any changes in the lecture timing and everything will be informed to you well in advance in the WhatsApp group and in email as well. So that is how we have spent so many hours till now, and 4 batches completed successfully. Then there will be a final exam. The assessment will be taken by IBSC. Apart from the final assessment, you will be having your internal exams, which will be conducted by Raj GPRSC. And you will be having mock test. And for the final test, we have kept 80 marks. The 80% is very, high level we have kept, because it is our wish to have a student at 80%, level, so that we get some, satisfaction. But it is not mandatory. I see to that after my training, our training, all my students get minimum 80% score in internal exams and the final exams. So, and after successful assessment, you will be receiving the certificate. The certificate would look like this. There will be, this is to certify that so-and-so, the name will appear in this and has successfully cleared the assessment for the role of Certificate in Biomedical Quality Assurance. The program number code will be given. The institution name will be Raj GPRSC Private Limited, and it will be signed dated. So this is a sample certificate which will be given to each candidate who will be passing the exam successfully. Then there will be the internal exams conducted by Raj Pharma e-learning. So we have our own LMS platform, that is learning management system, in which we will be given a user ID password, and through Knowledge Online, you can enter into this portal and simply give the exams. Okay, so the exams will be set online, in which you will see your course name, that is IBSC Biomedical. And if any announcement will be there, generally announcement will be published on WhatsApp only. So all exam set 1, set 2, set 3 will be uploaded on this website. And you can directly go to quiz session and, you know, attempt those questions. It will be pretty simple. There will be, suppose, 50 marks question. You will see to that. If the answer is correct out of 4 options, the number will be added into the right side. And then you can say finish attempt. It is very user-friendly platform which we designed for all of our students. Because many students are learning different programs. So under different programs, there will be different exams. All the exams or the test, I would say, will be of MCQ, that is multi-choice questionnaire. You can re-attempt, suppose if you feel uncomfortable or you are not confident to submit the paper, you can re-attempt and check your score and then submit your exam finally and finish. So that's how this platform looks like when we talk about our internal assessment. But the external assessment, the final assessment, will be conducted on IBSC portal, their website. Okay. So that website screenshot is not allowed because it is under government. So you will be guided by Nituri Naresh to have the final assessment. So you have to coordinate with Nituri Naresh for the final assessment and the certification. Okay. So thank you once again. And we'll start with medical device industry worldwide. That is global medical device industry. Okay. Before we talk about global level, let us understand the facts about India. Because I'm a very patriotic person similar to me, there are many. Because I love my India because of several facts, you know. You must be aware of 10 amazing facts also, but apart from that, India is the, you know, largest democracy. We are world's fourth largest economy also. We have the great scientists, IT, biotechnology, and the pharmaceutical world-class recognized industries. We are second largest English-speaking nation in the world and third largest standing army force, you know. So we have a great pool of scientists, engineers in the world. And I'm really proud, and we should be, you know, all of us should be proud, because we are second largest English-speaking country. Amongst top 10, if you see, USA, India, you know, and then there are several other countries wherein we speak English. So let us talk about now medical devices for which you are here. Medical device cluster is already well established in India, and AMTZ is one of the, you know, best medical hub you must have seen. And if you have not seen, you must visit once to AMTZ, you know, the MedTech zone, definitely. So I would request you to visit all these hubs. There are so many hubs coming up in India, like Haryana, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Karnataka. Tamil Nadu is already, Telangana is well established, then Delhi. And apart from this, I heard that Bihar, Goa, and many other cities also, medical devices park are coming up. Coming to now medical device classification. You know, India and Singapore, these are the two countries. Of course, Singapore is again APAC, that is not Southeast Asian country. So in both countries, if you see, the classification of medical devices are classified as class A, B, C, and D. Right from low risk, low moderate risk, moderate high risk, and the high risk. right? But what about other countries when we talk about global medical device classification? So India and Singapore has class ABCD, whereas other countries like US, Europe, Australia, Canada, and Japan have classified their medical devices as class 1, class 2, and class 3 majorly. But if you see Europe, Australia, they have class 2B, right? So class 1, that is steroid class 1 non-majoring, steroid class 1 majoring, class 2A and 2B. You can see the Europe classification. Then you can see the Australia and the Canada classification. Okay, so mainly you should remember that class 1, 2 and 3. And in some of the countries, class 2 is divided into class 2A and 2B. Okay. So medical device is nothing but it is any device intended to be used for medical purpose. So when you are into industry, you should learn about the intent for use, that is IFU, the label, what you are going to claim for your medical device, correct? So the claim, label claim and the IFU is the most important factor when we consider regulatory, you know, registration or any device master file or technical file preparation. So the IFU is most important factor apart from, of course, the classification. Then the third part is what country specific and the product specific requirement. As we discussed earlier, that product specific standards are different, like EN, ASTM, and ISIBI standard, that is, you know. So you have to follow country-specific standards, country-specific rules and regulations, and the product-specific standards. So these two things are extremely important when you want to make your career in regulatory affairs or in quality assurance, okay? So you should remember what? IFU, the country specific and the product specific regulations plus the standards. So medical devices, as I said, are available from head to toe, right? All over world, the medical devices are available from head to toe. Now you can see all types of medical devices are available for, you know, to cover our body part. When we talk about the legs, you know, all kind of implants. You will see hip replacement is available, knee replacement implants are available. When we talk about heart, there are pacemakers. When we talk about eyes, there are intraocular lenses, deep brain stimulator, MRI machine, ECG machine, so many simple diabetes check, you get the diabetic machine. So the whole world is moving towards the medical devices, and that is why the huge demand, huge scope for the medical devices. And you should see like during this next 5 years, huge demand. And to cater this demand, there should be a supply. And that is why the startup Make in India, all investors are coming up and investing into this medical device segment. So medical device benefit patient for helping healthcare provider diagnose and treat patients and helping patients overcome sickness or disease, improving their quality of life. Am I right? Simple, if the person is deaf, hearing aids are available, right? If the person have the eyes problem, we have intraocular lenses. Now even the dentures, even the invisalign, you might have heard, the old system, that is braces, have gone. Now it is replaced with the invisalign. So what is not available? Everything is available from head to toe, what I mean to say on this particular topic. Okay. So in world, if you see the medical devices top 10 company in 2021, you will find all this on intranet. If you Google, everything is available. I have taken all the slides, all the information from Google itself, and we have acknowledged the sources. If you see down the line, we have acknowledged the sources also. So coming to top 10 company, you can see Medtronic, Johnson & Johnson, Abbott, Philips. Then there are so many, right? So top 10 companies, you can find out from the Google. So the global medical device market reached a value of about $410 billion in 2020. My goodness, see the global size. So by 2025, how much growth it will be? Just see, we are here now, up to 410. So it is going to be, you know, beyond 612 billion. So the technological advancement are boosting the number of medical devices in the market and expanding their role in healthcare. So the compound annual growth rate, that is CAGR of global market for the medical device from 2020 to 2025 is 5.6%. You know, and it is expected to be, see, by 2025, 796.9, almost $800 billion. Isn't it a good news for you guys? So you are developing your career. So there is a great career in medical device. So there is an unprecedented increase in the manufacturing of ventilators that are used to treat COVID-19 patients. And because of COVID, you know, there are lots of opportunities opened up in medical device healthcare segments. So this is how the market size look like going forward beyond 2020, a rapid increase in the prevalence of infectious disease and increasing prevalence of chronic diseases will support the market growth. And beyond 2021, the global medical device market will be marked by an increase in the prevalence of infectious diseases and rise in the frequency of chronic diseases. And since the advent of COVID-19, the demand for medical supplies in vitro diagnostic, that is IVD also, you might have heard about MDR, IVDR, right? And the respiratory care devices have surged dramatically. So you will see this market, right, from medical imaging equipment, operating room and surgical equipment, patient monitor, cardiovascular, cardiology equipment, neurology, endoscopy, intensive care, and other medical equipment. You will see the growth, right? The market size. And this is the market segmentation, how it is segmented through North America, South America, Europe, and Middle East and Africa. And the Asia Pacific, of course, the APAC. You can see these are the segmentation, you know. And the North America medical device market was valued up to 197.215 million in 2019. And it is projected to reach up to 318 or 319 million by 2027. And it is expected to grow CAGR up to 6.4%. So it will remain, North America will remain the largest region during forecast period, mainly due to a large target patient pool coupled with a high adoption rates for advanced treatment in this region, right? As compared to Asia Pacific, USA, of course, the fast forward country, highly advanced technology and, you know, patient-centric country, I would say. And their major focus is to, you know, save each and every person in their country. So patient safety is extremely important in USA, Europe, and of course, our India is also following and making all stricter rules day by day. We are, of course, following international standards as per Europe. If you see our MDR 2017, we have adopted, you know, European guidelines only because MDD to MDR, when they have changed, we have also started changing right from 2017. And still there is a scope for improvement and all manufacturers are into the transition phase. Okay, coming to Asia, Pacific, Western Europe, the region, if you see the growth, you know, the growth will be, the CAGR would be 9.7 and 9.2 respectively. And about Middle East and Africa, where the markets are expected to grow, you can see 8.7% to 7.4% CAGR respectively. So coming to again the medical device market segmentation, by the it is always divided by the device type, you know, the type of device, then the type of expenditure, and by end user and by geography. So these four, the segment is divided with respect to what? Type of device, type of expenditure, and by end user and by geography. So you can see A to Z, you know, right? In vitro, till in vitro, dental, ophthalmic, diagnostic, you know, patient monitoring, nephrology, anesthesia, respiratory, neurology, wound care. You would see there are, you know, A to O. You can see these are the different types of devices. I hope you are listening to me, right? Then the again, the dental equipment and supplies market is further segmented by type of device. You can see the dental market is also capturing huge attention, and it's continuously growing. As I mentioned earlier, the braces is replaced with the Invisalign, you know, dentures, and so many things are coming into market. And the dental organ like teeth and are required in daily basis, right, for a healthy or the, you know, healthy people or the patient. So dental diagnostic imaging devices, general dental devices, then the dental surgical devices and equipment are in huge scope. So the global dental equipment market size was valued at USD's in 2020 was 5.4 billion, right? And it is to be grow, you know, the entire market, if you see region in the North America, is, you know, $308 million. So similarly, you can see the growth right from, you know, 2017 to 2023. So in every country, you can see the North America, then the Europe, right? America, Europe, APAC, and the ROW. ROW is nothing but the rest of the world. Means apart from this country, other countries. So this world is divided into regulated and the semi-regulated market. And there are almost 257 countries in this world. Okay. So how this market segmentation is done is, you know, shown in this slide. And the source is acknowledged. Coming to the ophthalmic device market, you can see vision care device, cataract surgery devices, diagnostic and monitoring ophthalmic, refractive surgery devices. This market is also huge. You can see there is a growth from $41.5 billion to $53.5 billion. You can see. Similarly, in vitro diagnostic market is also growing from 2018 to 2026. You can see point of care diagnostic device, immunochemistry diagnostic, clinical chemistry, molecular diagnostic, microbiology, hematology, hemostasis, then immunohematology diagnostic. There are so many types of devices. Even I'm not aware of this. So many devices, you know, in vitro diagnostic kits. Now, simple sugar check. Everyone has, you know, the sugar check device, oximeter. So there are so many devices, right? Then the diagnostic imaging equipment market, X-ray, ultrasound devices, computer tomography, that is CT scanners, magnetic resonance imaging device, nuclear imaging device, cardiovascular monitoring. So you can see the market, right? Right from the North America to Europe, EMA is Europe, Asia Pacific. Huge potential. Then the surgical equipment, same, you can see the growth. You see the growth, right? Then the patient monitoring device also, you can see the growth. Right from $19.5 billion to by 2025, it is going to reach by $27 billion. It's not million, it's billion, okay? By end user device, the medical device market can be segmented by end user, like home care products, hospital and clinics, diagnostic centers, laboratories, right? So this is also going to increase. You can see hospitals, academic, reference laboratories, medical device companies, clinics and all. Then wearable medical device market, right? The outburst of COVID-19 pandemic has extended the role of wearable medical device to protect our body, correct? So PPE is one of them. And then the smart watches, there is a huge demand for smart watches also, correct? Everyone wears now smart watches. So see how big is the market, correct? So here I would like to give the four tips for a good marketing strategy in medical device market. First, you have to understand who is your audience. So know your audience, right? Then decide whether to focus on medical professionals and facilities or end users. Then build industrial relationship. So building a relationship with the prominent practitioners help develop peer influencer program. Then embrace digital technology. Of course, now the artificial intelligence, AI, VR, all technologies are available, and you should take advantage of it, right? So rely on online and social media platforms to alert professionals about innovation in medical devices, and then employ content marketing, right? How you market the content is equally important. Correct? It should not be fake advertised or you are giving some wrong information. So integrate search engine marketing strategies to drive traffic from the potential customer. So the content marketing, this especially marketing, it is talking about your website, SEO, the search engine optimization, SMO, and all. And so these are the four tips for a good marketing strategy in the medical device segment. Then COVID-19 also impacts to the medical device market, as you are aware of, so it impacts to the medical device industry have redirected organizational priorities, placing a huge importance on responding to the ongoing crisis as opposed to other pressing unsolved health problem. So COVID highlighted issues with the outsourcing market and the product output. So since India has stopped, the import from the China and a couple of other countries are banned, and that's the reason India is, started their own supply chain channel, and there is a huge demand in this segment also. So nothing to worry if you are a biomedical engineer or any other graduate. Experience counts a lot. So whichever area you get an opportunity, try to grab the opportunity. And do your level best to perform your duty. And of course, along with your technical knowledge, your skills, you have to see that you should be good enough to project yourself. That is communication skill, effective communication. Then, of course, the people management skill. If you are short-tempered or any other qualities, like you have the behavioral issues, attitude problem. Then also it will affect your career. So how you make successful path that depends purely on you. So in Raji PRC, of course, along with your technical knowledge, we give the tips and hints for growing your soft skills also. So coming back to your again medical device market, there is a huge potential, as I mentioned. And you can see this presentation will be shared with you, and of course this lecture will be posted on YouTube for all of you to listen to me and other speakers. But the technical slides, the training program which we are going to cover from next Saturday onwards, nothing can be published because it is our intellectual property rights. Only the presentation, the training material will be shared with the candidates who have paid the fees, who have registered with us. Okay, so I hope you understand clearly, and of course there will be a question answer session after this my presentation also. So like I said, COVID-19 impact to the medical device market, the PPE and the ventilators are two categories in medical device that experience some of the most significant need throughout the pandemic, right? So because these devices were the most immediately necessary, they were the focus of many medical devices and consumer product companies, with some making the switch to the manufacturing these products to help alleviate production stresses. And in order to manage the spread of novel coronavirus, health authorities across the globe focused efforts on testing, which brought in vitro diagnostic to the forefront as another critical area of the medical devices. And with the release of COVID-19, of course, syringes are also even more critically necessary. So when there is a demand, there is a supply. As you said, COVID has given a good opportunity to everyone, you know, everyone, I would say. And that is really a good part to see the progress in India and other countries worldwide. Then there are some, you know, remote medical devices and consumer interaction, that is with the onset of stay-at-home orders and social distancing back in March of 2020. The past year forced consumers to find new ways to substitute daily routines and other necessary tasks. A greater push for elders to age at home and to treat the and monitor medical conditions remotely have caused both medical device companies and consumer product tech companies to develop new devices that aid in these areas. Correct? So large consumer product companies such as Apple have been implementing various health features such as ECG and heart monitors to aid in safety for the consumers. So now we talk about the opportunities and the recommendation for the students. So the top opportunities in medical devices market segmented by the type of devices will arise in vitro diagnostic market segment, which will gain from $23 billion of global annual sales by 2023. And the top opportunities in medical device market by end user will arise in the hospital and clinic segment, and which will again gain up to $130 billion by 2023. So this we are talking about the annual sales globally. Okay. Then again, the top opportunities in public healthcare expenditure segment, which will again gain $81.7. And the market size will gain the most in USA at $37.6 billion. So what are the recommendations to take advantage of these opportunities? Focusing on the development of wearable and mobile application, focusing on hybrid imaging technology to develop innovative imaging equipment, focusing on developing device with low ionizing radiation, and investing in developing technological advanced medical devices, and developing portable medical devices, realizing the demand from the customer and the consumers. So player adaptive strategy in this medical device market include what? Expand your product portfolio through strategic acquisition and the sustainable investment. Correct? So there are lots of mergers happening. I have seen there are lots of startups. There are lots of investors coming up and investing in these areas. Okay. So this is also one of my favorite slides, that is education. Think about it is an expense or the investment. Tell me, it is an expense or the investment? Of course, it is an investment which is going to pay you in later on, right? To have this course, you know, 15 to 20,000 is not a big amount. You will earn within a salary within a month, but the knowledge will be there forever with you, right? So if you think education is expensive, try ignorance. So this is also one of my favorite slides. The sentence is written by Derek Bob. And this is also one of the favorite sentence. I love this. And if you talk to a man in a language he understands, that goes to his head. But if you talk to him in his language, that goes to his heart. Am I right? So this is again one of the best slides, I would say, from Nelson Mandela. So our future is healthy. So please join us for this program. Those who have not taken the admission, please come ahead, take the admission. This is a wonderful program. You can listen to our previous student also. I have invited them also. And I'm really thankful to each one of you. Thank you once again for giving us the opportunity to interact with you. And now is the time to have question answer session. Thank you once again.